again. Tell them right now. That's a bunch of hippie homeless people now. Guys, cool. We have another guy coming here right now. Matt Collins. Who those of you who know K-Whale? Who knows K-Whale? Really?
Yeah.
I was not going to say this because last time I called him Alice, he threatened me. And we've both been drinking, so I'm okay with it. But he plays Alice on K-Whale. He also won the Doug Stanhope. Comic Idol back in 2010. If you don't know Doug Stanhope, Doug Stanhope is one of the funniest guys I've ever heard. Exceptional stand-up comic who acknowledged this gentleman right here. He's also a member of Questions with Quentin, his podcast. Big round of applause for Matt Collins, everybody. Thank you. Thank you all so much. Where's Quentin's family? Haha, front row! You guys could have done better. I'm just throwing this out there. I had to teach the guy how to fill up his tire. I don't know. I'm not necessarily, like, it's great practice to being a father, which I now never want to be. I'm now completely disappointed all of the time and frustrated. I'm like, eat the broccoli, Quentin! It's good for you! Enough with the Goomy Bears! But just an adorable guy. And you know what? He's the one that actually put this show together. So, I'm 11 years older than he is, and he is doing better than I am. So, let's get Quentin out here real quick, because he's going to be really embarrassed. My time to shine. Here we go. All right. What a handsome gentleman. That's a fantastic. So, you know, Quentin's actually taught me a lot about just what the kids are into, you know, these days. I'm learning for myself. This is based, like, I know I look really handsome today. You don't have to rub it in. But what I'm doing is, like, this is just what I think thin people wear. So, I'm just trying to trick them into thinking that I'm one of you, you know? Like, I'm gonna bust into your ultimate frisbee game and be like, hey guys, what's going on? What a bunch of young, thin people like us want to do. Who wants to climb some fences? All right. Who wants to get wine drunk and sit on kitchen counters? Because I'm all about that. Who wants to have sex before 10 a.m. and go buy avocados in our underwear? It's possible! We are thin, young, and beautiful. Everything is for us. That's why I have this beard, because every time I shave my beard, I just look like a 12-year-old who's raised by a family of Walmarts. Oh, man. Born and raised here in Alaska. How about you guys? Right? So many of us. Oh man, Anchorage, Alaska, not really a town on the go. We are just, Alaska is a state just covered in mountains, and it's like Alaska and the mountains are like a Lenny death hug, and we're the rabbits. Can't drive out of here. Of Mice and Men reference, how dare you, sir? This is a delightful banquet with a unicorn. I don't think we like these literary references here, unless it's about Excalibur. I was born here in Anchorage, Alaska. It's marvelous. It's great. It's just, you know, it just is what it is. Like, you talk to someone who's out of the state, maybe someone who, like, you know, got out or something like that, and they call you up and they're like, oh my God, Portland, Oregon's like one big farmer's market. This place is made of kale. Does Anchorage have kale yet? I don't know, but maybe. Probably. It's so amazing. So, how's Anchorage? Well, we got a second Olive Garden. We've got the last Blockbuster in existence, so I think we're doing pretty darn well. But what we lack in, like, ways to watch movies, we make up for in drinking. Alaska, big drinking state.
Yeah.
Right? There we go. Don't worry, you'll understand one day. It'll be fine. It's relationship juice, you know? You, like, loosen up a little bit, you're like, hey, Cynthia, there's something I always wanted to tell you. And then you sober up and you're like, oh, I gotta go. I gotta get out of here. That almost made a huge mistake. Yeah, big drinking state, like we tailgate our kids' soccer games. That's how much we like to drink here. If you're like my mom, you're pre-gaming before that. I'm not saying my mom has a drinking problem, because she's really good at it. But for her birthday, I got her an eye patch because I do not have an identical twin brother. There we go, that's the alcoholics for you, everybody. Anyone that laughed at that joke, they're like, oh! You find out who they are. My mom's idea of a square meal is boxed wine, so... I told her I'd stop telling these jokes, but... You guys are worth it! It's an absolutely amazing place. Absolutely amazing people. And there's something I had to do. I had to stop looking at food porn because it gave me... Hot crowd. Why don't you guys come to Coots, Everett? That'd be so nice. Oh my gosh, I feel so much better. Is it the $5 you had to spend? Is that it? Like, I'm gonna get my $5 worth. Food porn? Ha! Had to stop looking at food porn because it gave me unrealistic expectations of my meals. Not as big of a laugh as just the words food and porn. I'm just saying I can't look at food porn because, you know, I make grilled cheese sandwiches in the microwave. I've got no business with arugula. What is poached? You can teach me to cook. Instead of just feeling sorry for me, you can do something about it. You flip it? That doesn't mean anything to me. I ask what is poached and you go flip it. Honey, tonight I'm going to have you poached style. So, you flip it. So what I want to do is, Food Network is really popular, of course, and what the problem is there's no shows on the Food Network for guys like me. So here's what you can do something about it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a pilot for my very own show. So I'd like to give you a little sneak peek at my very own Food Network show. It's a little something we like to call Hello and Welcome to Cooking for One. Congratulations, you've lived long enough to require sustenance. What you'll need to do is set the oven to the perfect head temperature of 350 degrees. The ingredients you'll need are chicken breasts, beans, tortillas, and a sink to eat over. Don't forget about a bucket because we're cooking for the whole week here, people. And don't forget the most important rule about cooking for one. Chew thoroughly. Because there will be no one there to save you. These are jokes! I am never going to be able to afford to live alone. I would love to live alone. And, oh my gosh, that is my height of luxury, is just to be able to destroy a bathroom with impunity. But I moved in with my girlfriend. We just signed a lease, so now I am contractually obligated to have a girlfriend for a year. Or a really awkward roommate. We'll see. We'll see how this set goes. It's really great. Like, I know that she loves me for me because recently she bought a gun. Like, and I totally get it. I have been known to, when approached by a bee, I have used a woman as a human body shield. If we have intruders in the home, if my nudity doesn't scare them away, then I am all out of ideas. I really don't know what else to do. So now the problem is that my girlfriend has a gun, so she just wins every argument. There's really not much I can go at. You know, like, I can't even threaten to hit her. I wouldn't. But that's just not an option anymore. I know that's a little tough for you guys to swallow right now, but just remember, she's the one with the gun. Yeah, I got two guns, I get it, but she's got like the bang bang variety. And so now I'm powerless in this entire situation. The whole power dynamic of the relationship is all in her favor, so what am I gonna do? Get a gun. Then that's just gonna add to our relationships right there. Our arguments are gonna be totally different. She'd be like, hey, you wanna watch Sex in the City? I don't know, babe. I was thinking of hardcore pornography. What's gonna happen? Go to the ABN to find out. Thank you guys very much. Have a wonderful evening. It's been very pleasant. Lauren, everybody, I'm sorry for being so drunk.